How to set up parental controls on iPhone. Smart activity tracking and more stringent parental controls are a must for responsible parents. The stuff your child spends time with, the media they consume, and the adults they turn to for advice all have significant impacts on your child's developing worldview. Yo, you can never predict your child's future actions unless you have a firm grasp on their interests and how they spend their time while you're not watching. Finding that sweet spot is essential for parenting success. When it comes to keeping your kids in check, a powerful parental control tool like screen time may make your life much easier by providing you with deeper insights and more direct control. Let me show you how to set up parental controls on your iPhone so you can make the most of this useful tool for parents. The numerous parental control options available on iOS devices from Apple are a huge relief to worried parents. Why is limiting screen time so effective for parents? The seamless connection with Apple's own iDevices, including the iPhone, iPad, and Mac, is undoubtedly the best feature of Apple's screen time. The app syncs automatically with other iOS devices via iCloud, so you can monitor your kids' whereabouts from any Apple gadget. You may prevent and eliminate smartphone addiction by scheduling downtime to restrict access to all but certain applications during a given period and by establishing daily time restrictions for specific app categories. You can restrict your child's access to the kids' messages safety feature, which includes blocking explicit photos and preventing them from chatting with strangers. Screen time seems to have covered all the bases, what with its efficient features and the ability to ban inappropriate media including movies, TV shows, music, podcasts, books, and even bad language for Siri. You need first is to create a separate Apple ID for your kid to have more parental control over your iPhone or iPad. For a child's iPhone, screen time enables you to implement further parental controls. Make sure screen time is activated and adjusted for your child. Tap on Settings. Tap on Screen Time. Tap on Turn on Screen Time. Tap Continue. Select This is my child's iPhone. Set a schedule for breaks from your screen on the downtime screen. You can tailor your iPhone's permissions to only let in the apps you really need, along with things like phone calls and text messages. Keep in mind that allowing your kid extra screen time will be dependent on your approval. Choose a beginning and ending time that works for you, and then click Set Downtime. The fourth step is to limit the amount of time spent on specific types of apps each day. Your approval will be needed to extend the deadline once it has passed. Select the categories you're interested in by using the Show All Categories button. Then, limit the session duration by tapping the Time Amount button. Select App Limit then. Modify the preferences for content and privacy to your satisfaction. You may restrict access to mature content in the App Store, iTunes, and Apple Music, and even prevent access to malicious websites. Better yet, you can set it such that screen time will always ask for your permission before making any changes to the privacy settings. Tap on Continue. Create a passcode for screen time, which will be needed if you want to extend the time limit or make other adjustments. To restore or reset your screen time passcode, you'll need to enter your Apple ID and password. Screen time has been activated and adapted to your child's needs. If you need to make any adjustments, on the screen time section you will see the same options that you set up when you activated screen time. Let's talk a bit about the option you find here. We will talk first about content and privacy restrictions. Screen time is up to the challenge if you no longer want your child to view specific websites or if you just want to put all the hazardous websites on a blacklist to ensure your kid does not visit them. The limitation will affect not only the built-in Safari browser, but also other browsers like Chrome and Firefox. Tap on Content and Privacy Restrictions in the Settings app on your iOS device. To enable Content and Privacy Restrictions, toggle the switch and then select the option. Then, input the password for screen time. Then, choose Web Content and then limit adult websites from the menu. To add a site to the Never Allow blacklist, select it from the Add Website menu. Then, type in the URL of the site you wish to prevent access to, and click the Done button. Also, you can change settings for every type of video, book, movies, and so on. All you need to do is just check this section and set up it how you want. Let's get back to the main option to see what option do we have. You can also change the screen time passcode here. Modify your iOS device's downtime. There's a special downtime section in screen time that lets you restrict access to the device to just the apps and phone calls you choose during that time. The countdown timer alert appears 5 minutes before the downtime begins. Keep in mind that it will affect all of your iCloud-connected gadgets if you have share across devices turned on. Tap Downtime. Second, activate the Schedule button. Once that's done, you can adjust the amount of time and the days off you get. Moreover, you can disable the gadget during non-use periods if necessary. Limit applications on iOS and iPodOS and set permissions. With screen time, you can limit how much time you spend in each app category on your iPhone or iPad. Don't forget that if you have share across devices set, the app limits will affect all of your devices that are linked with the same iCloud account. 15 minutes before the cap is hit, a warning message will flash across the screen. To add a limit to an app category, just tap on Add Limit. When you click on a category, it gives you access to all the apps that fall under that particular heading. Select all of the apps you wish to have restrictions placed against them. Tap Next after you selected the apps. The third step is to decide how long the timer will run. By selecting the days you need, you can adjust the time frame. Then, as the timer runs out, the app will be disabled. Limit your child's ability to communicate with others, especially strangers, to keep them safe. Limiting your child's access to your iPhone's messaging features can help ensure that he or she does not share personal information with strangers. The use of phone, FaceTime, messages, and iCloud contacts will be limited. Select communication limits. Second, input your screen time passcode by selecting during screen time. Following this, you'll be presented with three potential next steps. Selecting contacts only will enable you to talk to people in your contacts list privately or in small groups. Select contacts and groups with at least one contact if you'd only like to be able to have private discussions with people who are already in your contacts list, or if you'd like to be able to have private conversations with groups that have at least one contact. If you want to enable communication with everyone, even those with unlisted phone numbers, you can choose everyone. Choose contacts only or contacts and groups with at least one contact to ensure your youngster does not have access to the phone's features but still cannot communicate with strangers. After making your choice, you can return to the previous screen by clicking the arrow in the upper left corner. Also, you can set up some contacts that are allowed to call and talk during the downtime. These are some of the parental controls you can use. The best way to use this feature is to check it out and take a bit of time to get used to it. After that, you will be able to protect your child from any harm. Thank you for watching this. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. You can watch more videos from the right. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.